It's best here around the world, WPAT 930am.com. Hello, Jeff. Hello, Carmine, hey, this evening. Hey, right here from Studio E, live in the studio. It's great to have Sondra Taylor right here.
Yes.
You're a part of the great toy. It's great to have you here on the air. New in the group, eh?
I'm
glad you're part of the show tonight. You certainly bring a lot of great depth to the program and a great depth of the toys.
Yes.
What do you like most about working with Barbara and Barbara?
Barbara's the best.
Yeah, talk right into that.
She's the sweetheart. She's the best. She's the best.
I feel the same way about her.
What you see is what you get. Never change. And Mike, she's the best. What you see is what you get.
Exactly.
Oh, sweet. Just their whole family. I'm part of their family. Words cannot express the gratitude that I have, because I left music for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I came back and I met Barbara, mm-hmm. and I can start out as a cookie with Margaret,
mm-hmm.
and the cookies, and then I had the opportunity to be a toy, and it's a great honor to be able to, do that. I knew the songs, and I heard, mm-hmm. you say, what is music missing today? And I'm going to say, as a singer, and a lot of singers come out, they don't study their craft.
Yeah.
And it's like, right. when we grew up, we know everybody's song. I know Lillian's song. I know that I can sing anybody.
Right.
Because we studied, we listened. Mm-hmm. Everybody now just want to get up there and don't study the craft. So this is like a dream come true.
When did you first meet Barbara? How did that come about?
I had a mutual friend that introduced me. They were looking for a singer for the Cookies.
Mm-hmm.
And this mutual friend, Otis.
Yes.
He kept seeing me. I was doing a solo act. I sing blues, mm-hmm. in Long Island.
You
so
sing
I,
some blues for us to sing.
Can she?
And so I was doing that, just singing around town, and he was saying, you got to meet Barbara Harris, the toys. You know what the toys is? Who don't know what the toys is? You know, and so from there, you know, and we just, the first rehearsal, I think it just, I knew
great
the songs.
Great chemistry too, right?
Yeah, the chemistry, yeah. And I knew the 50 songs too, because I knew
yes.
the cookie songs. And,
yes.
You know, and.
Actually, 8 years is relatively new. I mean, the group has been going on for how many years?
About
54 years.
Years. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not completely, but relatively speaking, yeah, 54 years, 8 years. So, yeah.
Yeah, I was. Yeah, I'm not that young. I'm 60, almost 63.
No
so.
Way.
Doesn't
look
good at all, right?
Well, 75. He looks 45.
So,
you
it's,
look 30.
It's still my era. It's more my. You know, you grew up listening to it. I was a little
right.
kid, but you know.
Right.
When you were a little kid, who did you like? Who did you admire as a singer?
Well, Aretha Franklin. Mm-hmm. Nancy Wilson was my favorite. That's
Nancy
what made
Wilson.
Me want to sing.
Mm-hmm.
The way she phrased her songs.
Oh, yes.
And I mean, I grew up around music because my dad was one of the Starlighters. He's Ann Taylor, he's a guitar player.
Mm-hmm.
And so I always was around music, and that's
did,
what I always
didn't your dad
to
play
do.
With Jimi Hendrix?
Jimi Hendrix took his place
oh,
when
okay.
he left
oh,
to
yeah.
go with Maxine Brown.
Right.
He wrote her sequel.
So he's playing with some
everyone.
Greatest entertainers around.
Yeah.
Musicians,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
Name a few others that he played with.
Well, he did some things with the Beach Boys. Made some things with the Drifters.
Just
with some Otis Redding. He's the one whistling on the dock of the bay because Otis
oh,
couldn't listen.
Really?
So
no,
I mean, we grew up, and I got a funny story. Mm-hmm. We were living in, and we're from Brooklyn, and we were living in Brownsville,
Otis
and we were living
listen.
In projects. And Dave and Eddie would come over, and we called them Uncle, and the kids would say, "How are they your uncles? They're white and you're black. They don't know." And we're like, "Those are our uncles," you know. And so just being around all the time and.
When was the first time you met Eddie Brigati or Dave?
You know, too many of you here.
Oh, hi, Tony. Good to see you, Tony. Good to see you, Tony.
You were
giving
me
when
emotion.
Did you first meet Eddie?
I had to been about
like
seven or eight. I was a kid.
You don't look like.
And so, like I said, growing up around the
music,
I knew I wanted to sing.
Thanks a lot.
But then my
really
father
not.
Made me go to school, though. So
I
took a 30-year hiatus. Became an educator. to sing a little bit, you know.
How do you like teaching these days?
I retired 6 years ago. I retired as a principal in middle school. And that allowed me to sing full time. But I still sang. I didn't stop.
Right.
When he would go out of town, I would be 14 sneaking in clubs singing.
You want to come back and sing some blues for us sometime? You do some blues for us sometime?
Sure.
She can sing anything.
I'm waiting
sing anything.
Do you have any other she telling places story that, over that you'll be singing in the near future, or a website, or anything that people can see on Facebook?
Yeah, I have.
Where are you in this?
I do. Well, in the Netherlands. I'm going to be in the Netherlands. We just finished
Amsterdam
is one. It's a tour. We did. My father ended up singing blues in his last years. And I have his band, and we just redid some of his songs. And so the album is finished. And so
let me ask you a quick question. Do you think I'm good without any notes, no script, no nothing?
I think you're wonderful.
Thank you.
You're excellent.
Well, thank you. That's why we have to have more live radio and people like Tony.
Tom Thomas.
Hey, Tony, you're the best. I love your hat too, buddy.
Talking about the blues.
Yeah.
She knows about the blues.
She knows
blues.
She's
not long enough.
It's 2 days.
Almost 63. I better know something about blues.
We're going to play something by Lillian Walker Moss from the Exciters. We're going to play Tell Him. We're going to talk to Lillian right after the song. And we're going to talk to John Scapoletti right here on WPAT Radio. Let's hit it, Rob, right here on WPAT, your most beloved radio station in New York.
I'm sorry.
I know something about love. Got a one in bed. If that guy's got into your blood, go out and get him. If you want him to be the very part of you.